Babe, I'm so sorry. I had no idea gun control used to be so racist.
Is that what you told her?
Well, I wasn't done.
So not my responsibility to teach white people their own racist-ass history. All right, White Urkel, I'll take it from here.
Please do, and thanks for the compliment.
Sarah, even today, a lot of gun control laws really end up being about controlling black people. In the mid-2000s, the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms performed 10 years of stings to combat gun crime. A full analysis found that 91% of people arrested were people of color. And we're not just talking about the red states. For years, New York City had an official policy to stop black and brown people on the street just to see if they might have guns or drugs.
Stop! Sir, you're in a public place and you look, you know, dangerous.
What? Oh, sir.
Records show that these stops almost never found guns. Between 2004 and 2012, 4.4 million people were stopped, but only 1.5% of them had weapons.
Men in my family have gotten jaywalking tickets from the NYPD after they didn't find anything in the stop and frisk. They weren't stopping criminals. They were just stopping black people.
Ava, I'm sorry. I had no idea. You've never talked about it.
It's not her responsibility to talk about it. It's our responsibility as a country.
This is James Forman Jr., Pulitzer Prize winner and author of the book Locking Up Our Own.
There's a connection between the overly punitive gun sentencing laws that were passed in the 1970s, 1980s, and 1990s and the current crisis of mass incarceration. Instead of national gun control laws that could stop the flood of available guns, we have local laws that penalize possession. And those laws are mostly passed in cities. So the result is that guns are everywhere, violence is rampant, and the only people who go to prison for possessing guns are poor people of color in our nation's cities.
Black people face the highest rates of deaths by guns. But instead of protecting the families and neighborhoods who face the most gun violence, our current gun laws just double down on destroying them.
And that's why we shouldn't talk about new gun penalties without first talking about how we transform our criminal legal system. All right, Adam, I gotta get to my Thanksgiving dinner.
Well, I think we all learned a valuable lesson about gun control.
No, Dan, that's something you need to realize too. Gun rights don't protect black people either. Take the Stand Your Ground law the NRA pushed legislators to pass in Florida. It says use of deadly force is justified to defend yourself in your home or car, even if you could run away. But in practice, not everyone gets to use it. Marissa Alexander was sentenced to 20 years in prison just for firing a warning shot to defend herself against her abusive husband. Stand Your Ground didn't help her.